guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna do another sort of round pour. The light is not very good, unfortunately. It's winter, and so if I open that up a little bit, if we can see a little more. So, but we got what we got. So, what I'm thinking of doing is sort of a not the light goes down again. A Dutch pour. On a round canvas. So I have white, pink, a really bright green and yellow together, some bronze with gold, silver, my turquoise teal blue, and my white. I think that's it. And I may or may not use some alcohol ink to just kind of make it a little more sparkly, because it's supposed to be a vibrant painting, which is Mardi Gras themed, I guess, or carnival, or whatever you want to call it. I guess I'm pretty annoyed with winter, that's for sure. Now we got a lot of lumps in here. I'm not going to do a regular Dutch pour, because I don't seem to have a lot of luck lately with it. I always put too much paint. So let's just do it kind of a mixed way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to put as much white paint on here as I can, whatever's left over from the goo that's in here. So yeah, you guys make sure you don't have any. I need to get bottles so I can keep it in there and then it won't dry up. But this is all from the sides, from the stirring. Speak English. Sometimes it's hard for somebody that doesn't speak English. Anyway, it should be good. This is again only with water. I don't have any float roll right now, and it seems to work fine. Okay. So it might be fun to put it in this, which is just a bottle cut off. Okay, let's move it over a little bit more so you can see better, make it a little bigger. It's actually in the middle, but it doesn't look like it. Move it a bit. There. Okay. So what should we put in first? Put this in first. Separate it a little bit. In the cup. Silver. White. Okay. Now what? So it's mostly blue now. The blue took over. Looks kind of neat though. It's a neat painting. Looks like a leaf. So it looks like it's not straight on that side. And then I want all the paint going that way. Need to try to prop it up a bit. Yeah, looks interesting. Let's go this way a little bit. I don't really want to move it too much because I like it that there's not as much paint over here. There's a little bit of there. For some reason it won't, the paint doesn't go over there. Oh, now it is. Pretty neat, isn't it? Where's my gold? Need to break it up with your hands a bit. And it forms a film and repels the paint. There's kind of cells forming, weird ones. So let's torch it. Trusty torch. Interesting, eh? This is the gold, okay. Fortunately, don't see much of the colors, but tricky with the white, with the round canvas, because it's got all these little folds in it. Doesn't always like you to... Okay, well, there's some kind of a bold spot. Let's not be bold. Looks like some of the bubbles are gone again. Or, I mean, it's tortured again because there's too much paint on it, but that's okay. Still a cool painting. Okay, let's want to see it from close up. Take you off. Let's see, what do you think? Again, this is, there is green in it, but it just looks more blue on the. Some little cells. Don't know, not sure if they're gonna stay, but I'm gonna look at the dried paintings in the next video. Okay, make sure you subscribe, like, and share, and watch that next video. And see what the other paintings I did already. There's a whole playlist. Thanks for watching.